Hello dear students, welcome to the last part of unit number 5 of the subject processor architecture and interfacing. In this lecture we are going to see the importance of receiver interrupt flag, that is RI, the importance of transmit interrupt flag, that is TI flag, and some of the examples of serial port programming of 8051 microcontroller. As we know that when 8051 microcontroller transmits the data to the external device which is connected to it, it transmits the data via THD line, THD pin of port 3. Before transmitting that data via that THD line, a byte character to be transmitted is written, is placed into the SBuffer register. After that character is framed, that is start bit, stop bit, and in between the start bit and stop bit, that character is placed. After that, the transmission process starts. A 8-bit character is transferred after the start bit. That means the first bit being transferred is your start bit. After that start bit, 8-bit character will be transferred via THD line. After that, a stop bit will be transferred. It is during the transfer of stop bit that 8051 microcontroller raises the transfer interrupt flag, that indicates the last bit of the character was transmitted successfully and the complete character has been transmitted successfully. By monitoring the TI flag, that is transmit interrupt flag, we can make sure that we are not overloading the SBuffer register. If we write another byte before raising that transmit interrupt flag, that is TI flag, the untransmitted portion of previous byte will be lost, and that's the reason we should put another byte onto the SBuffer register only after that TI flag is raised. After SBuffer is loaded with a new byte, that TI flag must be forced to the zero by using the instruction as clear TI to indicate that now 8051 microcontroller is ready to transfer a new byte. By checking the TI flag, we know whether or not 8051 microcontroller is ready to transfer the another byte. It must be noted that the TI flag after transmission of the data shall be raised by the 8051 microcontroller itself, and that indicates that it finishes the data transfer. And when 8051 microcontroller wants to send another data byte, then that TI flag should be forced to zero and it must be cleared by the programmer. And by using the instruction as clear, that is CLR TI, it indicates that now 8051 microcontroller can transfer another byte. If you write a byte into the SBuffer before TI bit get raised, we risk the loss of portion of the byte being transferred. TI flag or TI bit can be monitored by using two methods, that is polling method and by using interrupt method. In the polling method, you can continuously monitor the TI flag by using the instruction as JNB TI, target. And in the interrupt method, whenever data will be transferred via THD line completely, 8051 microcontroller will raise that TI flag and it indicates, and serial COM interrupt will be initialized. To handle that serial COM interrupt, 8051 microcontroller will call the interrupt service routine related to the serial COM interrupt, and that situation will be handled. Now let us see how to transfer a character byte serially in 8051 microcontroller. First of all, a TMOD register should be loaded with the value 20H. That indicates that we are using timer 1 mode 2 operation to set the baud rate and to transfer the data. As we have discussed in part 2 of serial port programming, that for the serial communication, we are specifically using timer 1 and mode 2. Why we are using mode 2? Because it is a 8-bit auto reload register. It consists of 8-bit auto reload register, and that is comfortable with 8-bit architecture of 8051 microcontroller. That means, as 8051 microcontroller can transmit a data of 8-bit as well as can receive a data of 8-bit at a time, this mode 2 will be supportive. That's the reason TMOD register is loaded with the value 20H, indicating the use of timer 1 in mode 2 to set the baud rate. After that, TH1 is loaded with one of the values to set the baud rate of serial data transfer. As we have seen in part 2, that we can set baud rate in 8051 microcontroller is programmable. We can set the baud rate as 9600, 2400, 2400, 1200, and to set that baud rate, we have to load some value into the TH1 register. If you want to set a baud rate as 9600, you should load the value as -3 decimal in TH1 register. You can load the value in the hexadecimal form also. There is no issue with that. If you want to set a baud rate as 4800, you should load a value -6 into the TH1 register. After that, SCON register should be loaded with the value 50H, indicating the serial mode 1, where an 8-bit data is framed with the start bit and stop bit. How that 50 comes, we'll see in the example. After that, timer should be started, and to start the timer, we have to set that timer run control bit as a timer run control bit 1 as 1, and that will be done by using the instruction as setb tr1. After that, TI flag will be cleared by using the instruction as clear TI. Why to clear the TI flag? Because after the data is transferred successfully, that is a single byte is transferred successfully, that TI will get raised, and to transfer the another byte of data, that TI should be 0, and that will be cleared by using the clear TI instruction, and that will be cleared by the programmer. The character byte to be transferred serially is written into the SBUFFER register, as we have seen in the previous slide, that before that data should be sent, we should send the data to the external device, that data should be placed into the SBUFFER register, and whenever the data will be received to that external device, that will be received through the RxD line, and after deframing, again the actual data should be placed into the SBUFFER register, and from that SBUFFER register you can move the data in any of the register securely, to store the data securely. Then the next step is TI flag bit should be monitored with the help of the instruction as JNBTI, target. Here we are using a polling method to monitor that TI flag, and to see we should monitor that TI flag to see if the character has been transmitted successfully and completely. Then if you want to transmit a second character, again go to the step number 5, that is first clear the TI flag bit to indicate that new character has been placed into the SBUFFER register and it is being transfer to the external device, and later on same steps should be followed. Now let us see one of the example. Write 8051 ALP to transfer a letter A. This is a single character A. Serially we have to transfer at baud rate 4800 continuously. Okay. So let us see the solution. First of all, we have to load some value into the TMOD register. If you observe the TMOD register here, there are 8 bits in the TMOD register. Above 4 bytes are reserved for timer 1, and above 4 bits are reserved for timer 1, and below 4 bits are reserved for timer 0. Now, in our serial port programming, we are not going to use timer 0. For us, these 4 bits will be 0000, Now, we are using timer 1. So, as we are know, we know why that gate is used. So, we are using a software method to start the timer. That is the reason this beat will be 0 for us. As we are using timer, this beat will be also 0 for us. And these two bits will specify which operation mode of timer we are going to use. So, as we are going to use mode 2, let me write here 1, 0. So, the complete value, that is 0010000B, can be loaded into T mode register, else you can load the value as 20H into the T mode register. Both are equal. After that, load the value of TH register with minus 6. Why minus 6? Because baud rate is set as 4800. How to calculate the baud rate and what value to be loaded into the TH register we have seen in part 2. If you want about it as 9600, minus 3 is the value you should load into the TH1 register. If you want about it as 2400, minus 9 should be loaded. And if you want finally the about it as 1200, minus 12 should be loaded in TH1 register. After that, load the value 50H into the SCON register. Now, why 50H? Let us see, there are 8 bits in a SCON register. Out of those 8 bits, SM2 is 0 for us, as we have discussed in the part 2. TB0, RB0 will be 0 for us, as we are using serial mode 1. As we are using serial mode 1, these 2 bits are serial mode specifier bits. As we are using serial mode 1, this value should be 0, 1. And reception is enabled. To receive the data simultaneously while transmitting the data, it is enabled, and that's the reason this RAIN bit can be 1 and this TI and RI bit initially will be 0. As we are going to transmit the bit, that TI flag will get set as a 1 once we will transfer the data successfully, and that's the reason the value is, this one is 5 and this one is 0. That is 50H is loaded into the SCON register. If you want to set send the complete value as it is, that is also okay. After that, start the timer. Timer 1, that's the reason timer run control beat 1 by using the instruction set B. After that, as we know that before transferring the data to the external device via TXD line, that data, that byte, that letter should be put into the S buffer register. That's the reason that A character has been placed into the S buffer register. After that, we have to continuously monitor that TI flag. Jump NOT bit. If NOT bit, that means if this is not, this TI is not 1, we have to wait here unless and until the complete byte, that is all the bits bit by bit with start bit and stop bit, has been transferred through the TXD line. Okay, after that, let us assume that this character A, that is letter A, has been transferred successfully. The moment stop bit will be there, the last bit, that is stop bit, will be there to transfer the data, this TI flag will get raised. And when that TI flag will get raised, 8051 microcontroller will understand that data has been transferred successfully. So if it is mentioned that continuously we have to send the data, that is letter A. So once we have sent the letter A, again we have to send the letter A. So again we have to jump here. Okay, and before jumping there, we have to clear the TI flag to indicate that second byte can be written on the S buffer register. So now for me, TI is equal to 0, and again I will send that letter A to external device. Before sending that, again I will place that letter A into the S buff, and again I will monitor that TI flag. When stop bit will be transferred, the moment stop bit will be transferred, the TI flag will get raised, and 8051 microcontroller will assume that data has been transferred successfully, that is character A has been transferred successfully. After that, again to transfer that letter A, clear that TI and jump to the again. Okay. So likewise, we will transfer the letter A serially at the bound at 4800 continuously. Let us see the second example. Write 8051 program to transfer Y. Previously it was only one character, that is A. Now there are two characters Y serially at the baud rate 9600. 8 bit data, 1 stop bit, 1 start bit. Okay. So as it is 8 bit data, 1 stop bit, 1 start bit, it indicates it is a serial mode 1. Baud rate 9600. Now T mode will be loaded with 20. TH1 will be loaded with -3. Why? Because here baud rate is 9600. SCON with 50, as we are going to use serial mode 1 with receiver enabled signal, and that's the reason SCON will be loaded with 50. Start the timer. Now send the data, that is character Y, to the external device. Now there are two characters. So what we will do? First we will place that character into A. After A, we will call the loop. In this loop, from A, the character will be placed in S buffer. You can directly send that Y character to the S buffer without using intermediate, that is accumulator. You can directly transfer, that is also okay. Okay. But here, to make the program simple, I have used A as accumulator. Now see, Y has been placed into the accumulator. From A, it is placed into the S buffer. After that, TI flag, it is monitored. The moment TI will get raised, when TI will get raised, when stop bit of this Y will be transferred. Okay, the moment stop bit will start transferring via TXD line, that TI flag will be set by the 8051 microcontroller, and the moment it will be raised, indicating that data has been transferred successfully. After that, second byte I want to transfer is E. So before that, TI flag will be cleared by the programmer to show that second byte, that is E, is supposed to be transferred. And now new byte is ready to transfer. Then again this E will be placed into the S buffer register. Again TI flag will be monitored to check that E has been transferred successfully or not. When the stop bit of E will start transmitting, the TI flag will get raised by the microcontroller. And after that, TI flag will be cleared by the programmer, because it is mentioned that Y and E, it has been sent continuously. So again, you have to come here. That is YE continuously. It will be sent to the external device via TXD line. But how it will be sent? First Y will be placed, will be copied to A. From A, that Y will be placed in S buffer. In S buffer, framing process will be completed, Y will be placed in between the start bit and stop bit. Then it will be transferred, and during the transfer, the TI bit will be monitored. When the complete byte will be transferred, that TI will get raised. The moment it will get raised, microcontroller will able to understand that S buffer is ready to take the second byte, and microcontroller is ready to send that second byte. Now for us, before that, that clear TI, that is transmit interrupt flag, should be clear. Okay, after that our second bit is E, byte is E. Now that byte will be again placed into the S buffer register, and again TI flag will get monitored. Likewise, this will be the continuous processor. So this is loop, that continuously, this indicates that continuously YE has been sent. Okay, I hope you have understood this example. Now let us proceed for the third example. Write 8051 ALP to transfer the letter Y serially at baud rate 9600 continuously and also send letter Y through port 0 which is connected to the display device. Now please check the difference here. This Y will be sent through THD line, but this N will be sent, this N byte data byte will be sent through P0 port. Okay, this N byte will not be sent through THD line. So T mode will be loaded with 20, TH1 will be loaded with -3 as 9600 baud rate, then SCON will be loaded with 50H as serial mode 1, IEN that is receiver enabled, start the timer, send Y to the S buffer first and from that S buffer complete byte which will be framed in between the start bit and stop bit, then the TI flag will be monitored to check whether the byte has been transmitted successfully or not. The moment stop bit will start transmitting and the TI flag will get raised to indicate that letter Y has been transmitted successfully, and after that we have to clear the TI flag. Okay, now it is mentioned that N has to be sent via port P0 and that's the reason that N is not placed into the S buffer. Only when the data has been transmitted via THD line, that is pin 3.1 of port 3, that is THD, in that case only that Y should be put, that should be placed into the S buffer. But if you want to send some data via some port, it is not necessary to place that data into the S buffer register. That's the reason that N can directly move through P0 which is connected to the display device, and this is a continuous process. That's the reason there is a loop. Okay, I hope you have understood this example. Now let us move towards the next example. Now this is similar to previous examples, but only the difference is in the previous example, that is in example number 3, Y was sent through THD line and N was sent through port 0, but here FF0 and 00H both has been sent through the THD line. How to send? Let us check. I hope this you have understood now. No need to again explain it. Let us transfer the data FFH through A first. That FFH is placed, it is copied to A. From A, it is moved to S buffer as it is necessary. Then monitor the TI flag. Then TI flag will get raised indicating that FFH has been sent successfully. Then clear TI flag because we want to send the another byte, that is 00H. Again, clear TI flag. So after TI flag, come here. Put the data into A. From A, that data has been transferred to S buffer. From S buffer, data will be sent to the external device, and while sending that 00H to the external device, the TI flag has been monitored by the 8051 microcontroller. The moment start bit will be transferred, stop bit will be transferred to that external device, TI flag will get raised, and the moment TI flag will get raised, it indicates that 00H has been sent successfully. Okay, and again clear that TI flag to send FFH. Why? Because this, it is mentioned that it is a continuously you have to send. Okay, I think in this example it is not mentioned that continuously you have to send. If continuously it is not written in the problem definition, then you can skip this statement. Then you can write in the, you can send the data once, that is also okay. So I hope you have understood how to transfer the data via THD line. Now let us understand the importance of RI flag first. While receiving the bit via RXD line port 3 of 8051 microcontroller, 8051 microcontroller goes through the following step. It receives the start bit indicating that the next bit is the first bit of character byte which is about to receive. As we have seen that while transmitting, that data should be frame, and by while receiving the data, that data should be deframe. Okay, but when the data will be deframe? When it is completely received. So 8051 microcontroller receives the start bit, indicating that the next bit is the first bit of character byte which is about to receive. Okay, after that the complete byte is received one bit at a time. After that the stop bit is received. When receiving the stop bit, 8051 makes that RI flag, that is receive interrupt flag, is equal to 1, indicating that the entire character byte has been received. Please make a note that in transmission of the data also, stop bit is monitored, and while while receiving the data, again stop bit is monitored, because stop bit is the last bit of the data byte data, okay, which is being transmitted or and which is being received. Okay, so 8051 microcontroller makes RI is equal to 1, indicating that an entire character byte has been received and must be picked up before it gets overwritten by an incoming character. It may happen that number of characters may be received. Okay, and we know that one bit at a time will be received at receiver's side, and that character should be packed in the byte size chunk so that we will get the data in the form of bytes. Okay, so what that RI bit does, that RI, that is a receive interrupt flag, indicates that we have to pick up the data. That means 8051 microcontroller has to pick up the data before it gets overwritten by the incoming character. By checking the RI flag bit, when it is raised, we know that a character has been received, the complete character has been received and is sitting in the S buffer. As we know that whenever the character will be received, after deframing, it is placed in the S buffer register. We have to copy the character from that S buffer register and we have to place that character in some of the other register. As we know that whenever the second character will be received, again that second character will be received in the S buffer only. So first character we have to store safely in some of the register. After the S buffer contents are copied into the safe place, the RI flag bit must be forced to 0 by using the instruction as clear RI in order to allow the next received character byte to be placed in S buffer. See, when the character is received in S buffer register, after deframing, that RI flag will get raised, indicate that there is a character in S buffer and pick up that character. Once that character has been picked up, there is nothing in S buffer register, then S buffer is ready to copy the another character which is being received after the first character. So to indicate that RI flag should be 0 and it will be done by the programmer. Failure to do this causes the loss of received character. Please note that whenever the data will be received, that will be placed in the S buffer, and whenever that RI flag will be raised, that will be raised by the 8051 microcontroller, and it will be cleared by the programmer with the instruction clear RI when 8051 microcontroller picks up the data from that S buffer register. If we copy S buff into a safe place before RI flag bit is raised, we risk copying the garbage. Okay, again in the same way, the way we have monitored TI, we can monitor the RI bit by using the two methods, that is by using the polling method and by using the interrupt method. In the polling method, we can monitor continuously that RI flag by using the instruction JNB RI comma target, and in the interrupt method, we can the moment that RI flag will get raised, the serial com interrupt will be initialized and 8051 microcontroller will jump to the interrupt service routine address to handle that interrupt. Please make a note that there is a single serial COM interrupt available in 8051 microcontroller for TI and for RI flag. Let us see one of the how to receive a character byte serially in 8051 microcontroller. The way we have transmitted, there are similar, almost similar steps. First of all, TMOD register should be loaded with the value 20. Then TH1 should be loaded with the one of the values to set the baud rate of serial data transfer. Then SCON register is loaded with the value 50, indicating serial mode 1, and receiver enabled. If that receiver enabled bit, that is REN bit, is 0, of course it is not possible for 8051 microcontroller to receive the data. That's the reason that bit must be 1. Then start the timer flag, use the instruction setb tr1 to start the timer flag. Then RI is cleared by clear RI instruction. Then RI flag bit is monitored with the use of instruction JNB. Here we are going to use the polling method to see if the character has been received successfully. When RI is raised, SBuffer has the byte and its contents are moved into the safe place. To receive the another byte, again we have to go to step number 5, that is RI should be cleared to indicate that SBuffer is empty and you can place another byte into the SBuffer register. Let us see one of the example to receive the character from external device. Write 8051 ALP to receive the data which has been sent in serial form and sent it out to the port 0 in the parallel form. As we have discussed, TMOD should be loaded with 20, TH1 should be loaded with -3. If you want a baud rate as 9600, here baud rate is not mentioned. So if you want another baud rate, you can load the value according to the baud rate. Load the value of SCON register with 50, indicating that it is a serial, you are using a serial mode 1 and receiver enabled is enabled. You are using a data framing of 8 bit data in between one start bit and one stop bit. Start the timer, clear RI flag to indicate that SBuffer is empty and you can place some data, some byte on that SBuffer. Then monitor that RI flag, because see, if this is 0, that means SBuffer is empty and you can place the data. But the moment it becomes 1, that means there are some contents in SBuffer register, and before that second byte will come, let us pick up those contents to indicate that RI flag should be raised by the 8051 microcontroller. After the byte has been received, that will be placed into the SBuffer register, and as we know that into the SBuffer register we should copy the byte from that SBuffer register to any other register. Here I have used A, but if you want to use any other register like R0, R1, R2, you can use. Okay, then it is mentioned that send that data which is received to the P0, to the port P0. So you can directly send that data A to the port P0. If it is not mentioned here, send the data to P0, no need to write the last line. And it is not mentioned that continuously you have to perform this reception of the data. It is not mentioned, so no need to write a loop here. So I hope you have understood the all four parts of unit number 5, that is input output port programming, timer programming, serial port programming, and the interrupt programming. If you have any query, please feel free to discuss. We'll meet you soon in the next lecture with unit number 6. Okay, I have referred 8051 microcontroller and embedded systems with assembly and C by M.A. Mazidi. Okay, so see you soon for the next lecture, that is for the unit number 6. In the unit number 6, we are going to cover how 8051 interface with different external devices, how 8051 interface with the external data and program memory. So happy learning. What we'll do, how much you have understood if you want to test yourself, then we'll have an assignment. I will share that assignment through Google Classroom. You solve that assignment and you check how much you have understood, and if you are having any query for solving that assignment, you can discuss with me. Okay, so we'll stop here. We'll meet soon in the next lecture. Thank you.